whole square or now how it works, let me take an example. Let's say I want to integrate dx by 2 sin x plus 1 the whole square.
Is that right?
Are you?
Yeah, try it.
Sir, can you give us a hint?
That's what, the hint itself is the theory.
Okay, let me discuss the theory here. Here we start with a term called p, which is cos x by 2 sin x plus 1. Okay. We call this as I.
Okay.
And we start with the term p, which is cos x by 2 sin x plus 1.
Okay, is there a particular formula?
This is a particular way to approach it. Now find dp by dx. dp by dx will be 2 sin x plus 1. Derivative of cos x is?
Minus sin x.
Minus cos x. Derivative of this will be 2 cos x by 2 sin x plus 1 the whole square. Okay. When you expand the term on the numerator, you will get minus sin x minus 2. Correct?
Yeah.
Now for the purpose of simplicity, just for the purpose of simplicity, so that you have to write less, take 2 sin x plus 1 as y. So what is sin x then? Y minus 1 by 2. Replace it here. So dp by dx will be, sin x can be written as minus y minus 1 by 2 minus 2 by y square. Can I write it like this? Okay. If I expand it, won't it become minus 1 by 2y minus 1 by y square?
No. No,
sir. Minus 2 by y square and plus, yeah, so it's half minus 3. Sorry, half minus 2. So it's minus 3 by 2. Correct?
Yeah.
Now put, after differentiating I got this, I took y as 2 sin x plus 1, which is this term itself, this term. So when I put it back, sin x will be y minus 1 by 2, so this sin x will be minus y minus 1 by 2, and minus 2 and I divide it by y square, this is y square. Now put back your y again as two sin x plus one, and minus 3 by 2, 2 sin x plus 1 whole square. Okay. Now take this dx on the right side. Let's integrate. You realize that integration of dp would be p, which I know. This is my p.
What is p?
This I can use half angle formula. Okay. And the last term, if you see, it's 3 by 2 I, right? So make I the subject of the formula. Done. You know this, I is a noun.
Sir, but how do you find P, sir? Tell us. How do you find P?
Why P is.
The rule is, if there is sin x over here, the P will have a cos x by this term without the square. If there is a cos x over here, P
minus
would be.
Sin x.
No, no, P will be sin x by a cos x plus B. Again, this is not there in the school level. Important.
Get to know that when you are doing this.
So, why do you
have to put P in this? How did I get to know that I have to put P as that? This is actually a reverse engineering that has happened. See, I have to create this square in the down. Correct? So the squaring will happen when you are following a quotient rule. Correct? So in following the quotient rule, you should have this term in the down. Correct? Now why did I start with the 1? Because had I started with the 1, I would not have got the term containing sin x on the top. Because I wanted to create a cos square plus a sin square terms on the top. That's why I started with cos x by this term. So I'm thinking in reverse fashion in order to generate the required integral. Try taking that as 1 by this term. You'd realize a lot of problems coming up. So by trial and error, let's say you put cos x and it started working out. So an algorithm was devised on basis of that. Most of these terms are, you know, they have been tried indirectly. And we reached to these algorithms. So just note this down.
Substitute sin x as the
hand. We'll continue with this even in the next class. We'll take a problem on this as well, both of them, and start solving it next class onwards. So we'll continue with the indefinite integrals. So today we'll start with discussing the type. This pair P of x is a polynomial with degree greater than or equal to 2. Okay. Now normally with P of x as a polynomial which is linear, we have already done it last class. Right? What was the approach there? We converted P of x as a times the derivative of this quadratic expression plus b. Correct? Then we found out the value of capital A, capital B, replace it back, and we applied our standard special integrals on that. Okay. However, this is the case where I have a polynomial which is having a degree greater than or equal to 2. Okay? Divided by under root of a quadratic expression. To explain this problem, I will take an example, because if I try to explain it in a generic way, you might get confused. So I'll just take a small example to explain the algorithm for it. Let's take this as an example. Integral of x square plus 2x plus 3 divided by under root of x square plus x plus 1. Now just listen to the approach very carefully and then we'll start solving it. The approach here is that we first see the degree of this polynomial. What is the degree of this polynomial?
2.
Okay. So 1 less than 2 will be what?
1.
Degree 1. So we'll write the integral of this as a degree 1 polynomial, which is b0 plus b1x, multiplied with this quadratic expression, that is x square plus x plus 1, plus another constant b2 times integral of plus b2 times integral of the same quadratic expression with the under root sign. Okay. Now this has been found out through observation that whenever integral of this type is being solved, the end result is always the same integral, the same function, that is the denominator function, multiplied to a polynomial whose degree is 1 less than the degree of this, plus some constant times integral of the same thing except for the numerator. The numerator term is not there. Numerator term is
that
1.
Is the final result.
This is the final result. So all I need to do is find my b0, b1 and b2. Okay. Had there been a cubic equation here, all would change is this expression. It will become a quadratic. Yeah, b0 b1x plus b2x square times this particular expression plus b3 times integral of dx by the same denominator function. Is that okay? Now how do I find my b0, b1 and b2? Very simple. For that, you differentiate both sides with respect to x. Okay. So, differentiate both sides with respect to x. So, what is the derivative of integral of something?
It's a function itself.
It's a function itself. It's the integrand itself. This is called the integrand. Okay. So, write down the integrand, which is x squared plus 2x plus 3 by under root of x squared plus x plus 1. Okay. Now, what is the derivative of this term? You can apply product rule on it. Right? So, first, let us differentiate the first linear term, keeping the other term as such. Then, keeping the first term as such, differentiate the other term, which is going to be
2x plus 1 by 2 root
of x. Correct? This is by the product rule on the first term. What is the derivative of this term?
It's a function.
B2 by? Yeah, the function itself, the integrand itself. Okay. Now, I just have to compare the coefficients. But before we do that, we'll multiply both sides with 2 times under root x square plus x plus 1. Okay. So this will become 2 times x square plus 2x plus 3. This one will become 2b1 x square plus x plus 1. This one will become b0 plus b1x 2x plus 1. And this will become 2b2. Is that okay? Now let's start comparing the coefficients of x square first. What is the coefficient of x square? Left side, what is the coefficient of x square? 2. What is the coefficient of x square on the right side? Can I say it's 2b1
plus
and 2b1? So 4b1?
So you took LCM
on the left side. You can say, I took LCM and took the LCM on the left side. Or you can say I multiplied both sides with 2 under root x square plus x plus 1. So this implies b1 is going to be half. No doubt about it? Similarly, let us compare the coefficient of x on both the sides. So on this left side, your coefficient of x is going to be 4. That's 2 into 2. On the right side, it's going to be 2b1. Can I say it will be 2b0? And can I also say it is going to be b1? Yes or no?
Yeah.
So 3b1 plus 2b0 is equal to 4. And b1 is already known to us as half. So 4 minus 3 by 2 divided by 2 will be your b0, which is going to be, if I am not wrong, 5 by 4. Okay. Yes.
You equated it and cancelled. I mean, you opened all the brackets and cancelled right side and left side. How do you get all that? Is equal to 4?
I don't have to open it to compare it. I can compare on the go also. Okay. Now let's say I want to compare the coefficient of constant term. So left side we have a 6. Correct?
2b1.
Right side I'll have 2b1.
Yeah.
So I'm just picking out, I'm hand picking out terms which are constants on the right side. So 2b1 will be a constant, b0 will be a constant, and 2b2 will be a constant. Yes sir. Now put the values. B1 was half, right? So this will be 1. B0 was 5 by 4. This is 2b2, which implies b2 is going to be 5 minus 5 by 4 into half, which if I am not wrong is 15 by 8, right? Okay. Now, our 90% of the job is done. You just place the values. B0 is going to be 5 by 4. B1 is going to be half. B2 is going to be 15 by 8. And yes, I have to complete this integral. That is easy. This integral I have to find out, right? Right? How do I do that?
Using
the special integrals which we discussed. Correct? Yes or no? Vishal looks at that. Is it?
You can capture the square in the
chair. That's
correct. Don't worry, we'll take one more example. Okay. Yeah, we complete the square over here. So basically, if I'm not wrong, this is going to be x plus half the square plus root 3 by 2 square, correct? Yes or no? Which is going to fall under the formula dx by under root of x square plus a square. Nikhil, what was the integral of dx by under root x square plus a square? I'm searching for the formula now. dx by under root. If there was not an under root, yes, then you were correct. ln x plus under root x square plus a square. I replaced them in wherever there was a b0, b1 and b2. That's it. And there was an integral which was, there was an integral which was supposed to be evaluated, so I am going to evaluate it now. This result is going to be, can I erase this? This result is going to be ln x plus half plus under root of, is that okay? Plus c, and your job is done. So this is going to be your answer for this question. Okay. Achha, did we do some practice on the last slide that we did a plus b sin x whole square? Just remind me to do one question on that also. Meanwhile, I'll give you another question on this.
Yeah.
But I will repeat the entire process once again. The entire process is, whenever you have an integral where you have a polynomial function of degree greater than equal to 2. Linear, you know how to read. Last class I talked about it. When the polynomial is of a degree greater than equal to 2 divided by under root of a quadratic, only then this algorithm is followed. In this algorithm, what do? We take a degree lesser than the degree of this polynomial. For example, in this case the degree is 2. So I take a linear polynomial, which is this, but I would write it as b0 plus b1x. I don't know what is b0 and b1 as of now. Times this quadratic under root plus another constant, let's say b2, integral of 1 by this function under root of x square plus 1, x square plus x plus 1 dx. Now how do I get b0, b1, b2? By differentiating both sides with respect to x. When I differentiate this with respect to x, I get the same function back. Right? And here I would apply chain rule, product rule. Integrating both sides. And then we start comparing the coefficients of x square, x and constant from both the sides to get my value of b0, b1 and b2. Place it back here. It's just that one thing that you need to evaluate is the integral of dx by under root x square plus x plus 1, which you can easily do by completing the square and following the standard integral formula discussed the last class. Can we have one more example?
So what if the root wasn't there?
Then this approach will not be applied. Then you would divide it first.
And what about if like both?
Then you would divide it first. You will get a quotient, you will get a remainder.
No. Okay, you use factor.
I think you got confused with that in Adi Sharma.
No, no, this is
this only.
This is by
yes,
sir. I'm not sure if it is root of x plus dx plus c, but that is
there. No, if there is no root, then partial fractions.
No, if there is no root, the approach is completely different. Different. If there is no root here, then we first divide it.
Yeah.
We divide it, we find the quotient, and remainder would either be a linear term or a constant term. Okay. Then you would follow the standard integrals or the approach which I discussed. With the root, it becomes this approach. So please be watchful in the exam, do not get confused within the types itself. This type should have an under root of a quadratic in the denominator, and numerator should be a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 2. Next problem we'll take up on this. Can I clear this up?
Yeah.
Yes, this is going to be a long method, but this is, I mean, yeah, this is the only method.
Did they ask you questions today, sir?
They may ask.
And they ask you.
The reason why we are studying it is somewhere they have asked.